That's so cool.
So didn't you used to do a lot of the molds?
No, that was, I see you. There's the video on how you're making the thing.
My neighbor is an artist over here. Does the big heads? You know, you've probably seen those.
Yes, my grandma. She's been over.
Yeah, and she was asking. I guess you can push this into an existing mold too.
Yes,
yeah?
You can.
How wet do you get it? Do you get it like brown sugar consistency? Is that the best, or
it
wetter than that?
It doesn't go to that consistency. It's a dough. It feels like cookie dough.
Okay.
So
you just use some sort of mandrel or something to push it. Yeah.
Typically, if we're going to put it in a mold, what we'll do is mix it up to the dough consistency, spray an area, and then rub the surface with the material, and it'll part a film that will pick up all of the detail. And then we pound
it. What do you spray it with? Moisture? Water?
Yes.
Just get it wet?
Yeah.
I didn't know if you really vegetable oil or apples or...
Nah, we like water.
Yeah, that's great. Just want them. Okay, so you spray it, and then...
Mm-hmm. Making a tinfoil orchid, and then I cover it with this clay that we're selling that allows it to go outside, so it's not ceramic, it's an open face, and it can go outside even if it freezes and thaws and freezes and thaws and rains and snows.
So in the middle of this is the tinfoil.
So you can see really well on this, and it's created a really nice tinfoil fish. And if you do the rake, you can come back at any time, months later, and finish it.
Oh, interesting.
But I usually like to finish the thing in like a couple hours.
So you do a tinfoil and then you coat it?
Mm-hmm.